man. This is live. Anything can happen.
And what if you fuck up?
Man, this is live. Anything can happen.
I'd be pissed scared I'd get a ball or something.
Man, this is live. Anything can happen.
Shut the fuck up, man. You're making me nervous.
The interesting thing is they call it pyroprocessing, but it's a molten salt process. They're dissolving this thing in a molten salt, and they're doing electrochemistry on it.
Welcome back, guys. Pop culture in the morning. Back with the same old video clips. I said I was going to get some new ones, and I didn't, but I got deleted some of the ones. Sorry, I almost knocked everything over. Hopefully, we're going good. Therefore, I had a trouble getting this video to start. Hopefully, we started. Everything's going good here. Okay, let's see what we got going on today. We're going to talk Nintendo. Well, not just Nintendo. We're going to talk home video games. We're going to mostly look at Atari and Nintendo. I mean, everybody, some people had the television and some people had, you know, ColecoVision or whatever and all that. But most of us had either Nintendo, probably Nintendo from mid to late 80s. And then before that, the 2600. Sorry if I'm going to sniff and I'm going to try not to. Throat's not hurting anymore. That's good. Back of my eyes hurting for some reason, and still nose is bothering me, so should be good to go, I think, anyway. So how was your day out there? Let's see, we got 15 people in the room. We are cranking it up today. We got Raw Solo always here ready to hang out, and of course we got Chris Caldwell taking down names. We got Dan Atari, we got Plastic Toy Feet, Plastic Toy Hunter, sorry about that, Plastic. We got Johnny. We got Rich. I don't see Ashley. I don't see Samantha the Sledgehammer. I don't see others. We're going to talk a little slow here because a lot of times people don't come into the chat until later. A lot of people don't like to click on it and wait. They wait till the live stream starts and then jump on into the room. Hopefully we got some new people here. Like Smack Talker Skywalkers come here to talk some smack. But he says I have a nice shirt. So he's not talking smack right there. Mason's here. Steve's here. Don't forget to send in a super chat. Make sure I see it. Get you a video clip play that you've probably seen 100 times before until I get some new ones and get off my lazy butt. And what else? I don't know. Send in a super chat. Wait, I'm making sure I see it. And it also supports me doing more live streams. Because to be honest with you, when it comes to the live streams, the ad money is like 76 cents. So I'm not here begging for money. I'm just saying it really helps out. So it's more than just, hey, just give that guy some money. You know, super chats really help bring out the live streams. Hopefully you like the new. We get into a video yesterday about Boshack. Anybody remember Boshack? A character I always loved in Star Wars, although you only saw him for like that long. Boshack. Just think of what could have happened to Boshack's life if he took that charter that Obi-Wan was trying to get him to take. He would have married a princess. He would have married Princess Leia. He would have helped save the rebels. But who knows? I guess it would be a whole different chain of events, too. Because, well, they wouldn't freeze him in carbonite. They wouldn't have to go after him. So maybe they would have took down the Empire long before that. But who knows what would have happened if Boshack. I mean, Boshack might have been a bumbling fool. He might have never been able to rescue the princess or get out of the Death Star. Hell, he might have just, when the Death Star got sucked in the Death Star, he might have been like, hey, I'm just taking these passengers somewhere. Here, take them. I don't know who they are. I ain't risking my life for these people here. But who knows what Boshack would have done. Oh, maybe I need a shirt. I need a Boshack shirt. Is there a Boshack shirt out there? I doubt I can find a good image of him that's in good quality. I would have to get someone to draw a picture of him for me, maybe. Samantha the Sledgehammer is here. I said earlier a minute she wasn't in here, but maybe she isn't. I always wondered what happened to the Cantina Band. Yeah, what happened to the Cantina Band? Hopefully they still pulled out. So I heard they did a reunion album about 20 years ago. I don't know What the hell happened? I don't know. What the hell? Somebody's outside working on a house. They were hammering and shit this morning. I was trying to sleep like 7 o'clock this morning. I said, what are you doing hammering and shit? Hammering and sawing. And I was like, God dang, that somebody, and up that way, is cutting the grass again. I didn't know I had so much grass in this neighborhood. Oh, people, them trying to get, well, let's do something a little different. Might be fun, might not be fun. Let's look at today in history. That's what they always do in them AM talk shows, and I always find them boring. But let's first start with Star Wars history. 1981, March 31st. What happened in Star Wars history on March 31st, 1981? The Empire Strikes Back won Academy Award for Best Sound and Special Achievement Award for Visual Effects. I don't know if I stayed up to watch it. I do remember staying up in 1980, I guess it was 81, watching the Academy Awards because Raiders was nominated for Best Picture. And I just wanted to see a clip of it. I didn't even know if it was going to win or not. But I remember, I don't know why I have such a memory of that, 1980. Sorry. Oh, God, I'm choking here. I remember falling asleep, watching it on my little black and white TV I had in my room. But I fell asleep before it came on. But I remember seeing clips. I think they were like, coming up. Best Picture or something, and it would show Indiana Jones or somebody there showing it. But I remember the boulder scene. Oh man, I could listen to Junkman all day. Indiana Smith will come back to 97. Where's Indiana Jones talk on Wednesday? Wednesday we talk Indiana Jones. Although most of the time the first 15 minutes is what with the topic, and then we drift off somewhere else. Never know where we're gonna drift off to. Are you sure there wasn't building stuff? They might have been. No. The Boshack video made me order. It made me want the figure too. I had the figure, I think, when it first came out. I don't have it anymore. Sold a lot of my 90s stuff, 2000 stuff years ago, for a lot less money than I should have, probably a lot less than I had invested in it. But it made me want a Boshack. I was like, I need a Boshack. I wish they would do a retro. You know how they do the retro figure? They always throw one that wasn't made. Throw in Boshack, man. That is awesome. So I'm glad you guys enjoyed that video. Oh, shit. Glad. Oh, man. Oh, shit. Let me call for real quick, guys.
Hi, baby girl. Everything's okay. I promise. I forgive you. It's okay. Don't.
Man, you see that shit, and you're like, no wonder Samantha Sledgehammer don't like guys. Shit. Got that shit out there, and I'll be turned off to guys forever also. Ooh. Penises. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, the Boshack video. I'm glad. At least the. I was just so amazed that no one, people did not click on that Obi-Wan video. I think what it was is I released it late at night, like midnight. My 10 characters I like to see in the Obi-Wan series. And also the thumbnail looked kind of like the live podcast from earlier that day. So I think people thought, oh, that's just a podcast. I'm not going to click on it. Well, live stream, I mean. So I'm not going to click on it. Or they think, oh, that's just a clip from the live stream, that segment uploaded. But it was a whole new video. So if you didn't see the 10 characters I would like to see in the Obi-Wan, so check that out. It really, really tanked the performance. It's starting to pick up now a little bit, but I think it's because I didn't do it at 5 o'clock like most of my daily videos lately. And I just random threw it up about midnight, which is a bad time. Even YouTube said, less viewers are watching, and said this is a bad time to upload for your channel because they show us best times of day on my channel to upload. And that's not good. So I should have just made that video and held off on it, but I don't know. Tomorrow is the first day of April. March is over tomorrow. Tomorrow's going to be fun. Let's see. We got Smack Talk Skywalker said, man, that kid is creepy. He is creepy. That's why I like praying it. Playing it, because I don't think there's anything on YouTube as cringy as that. Unless it's probably a Kroger commercial scene. Like, Junkman, I saw your reaction to Bad Batch. You should make Junkman silent movies. There we go. I did do a silent video one time, like when I did, why's my collar feel like it's coming down? I used to do a Monday's action figure review, and I would get bored with it. I'll do something different. And I think I did a review of an Ewok figure, but I did it as a silent movie. Black and white, fast motion. It was fun. I always like to, you know, change things up a little bit if I can. Always a little fun there. I think I did one that's actually backwards. Did a video of the review backwards. That's what I liked about doing those reviews. Junkman, I saw you. Oh, I read that one already. Bad Batch, I just didn't. Was that just me or was that Rambo in Bad Batch? I mean, Stallone should sue him for likeness. I mean, really. I ain't seen anybody rip off something that bad since I saw Contra. How did Contra not get sued there? I think it was a ripoff of Aliens. Arnold, Stallone, all of them, man. I watched the trailer. It's good. It looked okay. I guess it looked good. I mean, it looked like Clone Wars. I just don't like the animation style. It just bugs me too much. And people ask me, let me pull this up. People say, why don't you like the animation? What's wrong with the animation? Let me just show you. So I saw this today, and I think it's from New. And I was like, this looks so, I thought I crashed the system. That would have sucked, wouldn't it? I did that one time. I was like, let me pull this up. Now I end up crashing the system here. I don't know if I still have it. Let me see. Sorry. I know. It's live. This ain't very professional. I was like, okay. I guess I didn't save it. I thought I did. Probably lost it when I was moving all my other stuff on here. Oh, well. I thought I had it. It's two girls. It's from the long... And one of them's like, she's got grapes on top of her head. It's just so weird looking. And the other one's got like half her head shaved and it's flipped over. And just something about just both of them just the sight of those two. I don't even know who they are. Makes me not even want to find out who they are. I don't know why they're so weird looking. Why that lady has grapes on her head. Oh, I think we got a new alien flick in the near future. They have dug that Aliens franchise into the ground, hadn't they? Oh, man. Yeah, Stallone took down my bootleg shirt. What's up with that? It actually said it was from Sylvester Stallone. It didn't even say from a corporation or anything. That was odd. Like, I can imagine him, you know, searching across website. Hey, that looks like me. It was weird because I have an over-the-top shirt. Never took, no problem with that one. Had the over-the-top logo. Yeah, the Alien franchise is strong. Maybe, I don't know. I like the first two, and other than that, I dropped off with it. Dan said he liked the trailer. I'm glad some people like it. Just wasn't my style. You'll see what Walmart issues Transformer with me and white figure. It's badass. Sounds pretty badass. Oh, I was looking at the history. The day in history. So we did Star Wars. Let's go just back pop culture history. Let's go back, man. No, I'm not going to go back to 1822. Come on now. There's nothing. Nothing to stay in the 70s, North Newton. It don't look like on this website anyway. 1981. A new single cell energy life pattern. I don't know. That sounds boring. 1984. Number one hit. This day. Number one song. Kenny Loggins. He was kicking off his Sunday shoes. This would be the worst line in any song ever. Kick off your Sunday shoes. Kenny Loggins was Footloose. Footloose and Fancy Free. 1985 was... I bet some of you guys know this. What happened? Don't cheat. What happened today? For the first time in 1985. I'll see if I can give you a hint here. It might be too easy. It happened at Madison Square Garden. Let's have a go to the chat. Suhu can get that while I clear my throat real quick.
I tried this one chili and it set my mouth on fire and I had to drink a 2-liter of Mountain Dew.
Bad timing. Okay, let's see who in the chat can tell me what happened. Don't cheat, don't Google. What happened? 1985. This date in history, 1985 at Madison Square Garden. I know. You're probably thinking it's a Statler Brothers concert that sold out, but no, it was not the Statler Brothers concert. Is the chat frozen, or are y'all just trying to Google really quick? Robert said they're going to make an alien TV show. I am curious about that one right there. Should be interesting there. Anything about Micronauts movie or show? Haven't heard anything about anything Micronauts related. I was going to do a video about a bootleg Micronauts series. Jim says, wrestling. Should we give it to Jim? Should I give it to Jimmy? Because he is close, but I was looking for something a little bit more. WrestleMania, Robert Long. That's what I was looking for. WrestleMania, the first WrestleMania, Madison Square Garden in New York City. WWF, as I call it, or WWE, whatever one you prefer to call it. Also in 1987, on this date, Max Headroom, the television show, premiered on ABC. 1994, Madonna appeared on David Letterman. Well, started up controversy. Remember that one right there? She was saying some bad words. She was bleeped out 13 times for cussing on the David Letterman show. Oh, man. I love David Letterman. And that was probably CBS 1994, right? I like him better when he's on NBC. But maybe it's just my age. 1995 today, Latin singer Selena was murdered also. There you go. But that's some look at history. Let's see whose birthdays today. Because I know one of them. Let's just see here. We'll really hack this thing up, man. We'll be like a couple of AM, FM radio hacks. So everybody, birthdays today. Because I know one. What? Did not know that. That one I did not see. Well, this one wasn't trending. Today's birthday is Ewan McGregor. Happy birthday, Ewan McGregor. How about that? I didn't even realize that was his birthday. Born 1971. Happy birthday, Ewan McGregor. I'll put that up on. Now, number two. Well, I don't know they're right in order. Christopher Walken's birthday's today. Christopher Walken. That's who I saw on Twitter. Everybody was saying happy birthday. Everybody forget about Ewan McGregor. Born in 1943. Christopher Walken's birthday is today. See if there's anybody else of note here that I can think of here. I don't know who that is. Al Gore, the man who invented the internet, his birthday today. Get there. I don't know who that is. Sebastian Bach. I think he was some heavy metal guy in the 80s. Born in 1685. He is old. Let's see here. Rhea Perlman's birthday today also. Rhea Perlman there, Danny DeVito's wife. I think they're still married, right? Probably one of the longest relationships in Hollywood if they are. Don't know who that is. Henry II of France. Hate Henry II of France. Henry XI is my favorite France. My favorite France. I don't know who that is. Angus Young. His birthday's also today. I did see that on Twitter also. Hey, Ewan, why ain't Ewan getting any love? Angus Young. I feel like this caller's too big. Angus Young from AC/DC. His birthday's today. Born in 1955. Prince Henry of Duke. I don't know who you are. Shirley Jones from the Punchers family has a birthday today. She was born in 1934. I didn't realize she was that old. 1934. Crazy. Richard Chamberlain. Isn't he dead? I could be wrong. Is Richard Chamberlain dead? Let me know in the comments section. I mean, let me know in the chat right there. Jack Johnson, the boxer's birthday today. Happy birthday. I don't know you. I don't know you. I don't know you. Never seen you before. Don't you? You look stupid. You wearing a wig. William Daniel looks very familiar. I don't know who you are. Well, you look very... Steve Bing. I don't know who you are either, but your face looks familiar. Don't know you. Never seen you before. Hope I never see you again. Yuck, go away. Goldie Howie. I don't know who that is. Thought I said Goldie Hawn. I don't know who you are. You got the ugliest beard I've ever seen. That's not, you're the wrong Eisenhower. I don't know what you are. Well, you got jaundice. Yeah. Hal Linden's birthday today. Barney Miller himself, born in 1931. Whew, getting on up there, Barney Miller. Barney Miller. I always liked Barney Miller. I like to see that actor, Hal Linden, in more stuff. I think he would have been a good actor. I mean, I'm sure he did other things also, but I don't know. He's always really good at Barney Miller. Let's see if there's anyone else. I don't know you. Don't know you. Don't want to know you. I don't listen to that type of stuff. Gabe Kaplan, happy birthday to Gabe Kaplan, man. That man, talk about a cool-ass actor in the 70s from Welcome Back, Kotter. It's Gabe Kaplan's birthday, born in 1945. Happy birthday, Gabe Kaplan. What a day for birthdays, man. We gotta do this more. There's a lot of birthdays. Gabe Kaplan, the man, the myth, the legend, the sex machine himself, Gabe Kaplan. Happy birthday. Don't know you, don't know you, don't know you, don't know you. I don't listen to that. I don't. You look familiar, but I don't know you. Shit, this guy was born in 250, it says. Can't even pronounce that name. Don't know you, look familiar though. Don't know you. If I don't know you, everybody was like, who are these people you don't know? Don't, come on. Some of these names can be let off. They're using the. Born today. This is special to my heart. Lottie, you gonna say who? Lefty Frizzell. Now, as a guy that grew up on country music, I know Lefty Frizzell. And thank you, Dwight. I know Lefty Frizzell. What a great country singer. Died in 1975. If you don't know Lefty Frizzell's music and you're into real country music, check it out. Oh, Lefty Frizzell, man. Aaron. Anna Carter, one of the Carter sisters, also his birthday today for the Carter family. That guy's dressed like James Bond. Don't know you, don't know you. You look like you might have been in the Power Rangers, but I'm not sure. I don't know if you were a boy or a girl. Shit, there's a lot of birthdays today. They're taking this celebrity thing too loosely, though. A lot of birthdays today, though. God, Lord, there's a lot of birthdays today. Shit. It says Henry Morgan. Sorry about that. It says Henry Morgan, but it doesn't look like Henry Morgan. So it might be the guy from Ash's birthday or not. And it might be a different Henry Morgan. Because it didn't look anything like him. Jeff Young. I don't know who that is. Maybe some of you says he plays the guitar. You look like a rock and roller guy. God, Lord, how many birthdays are they? Jesus. A lot of people born today. A lot of people was having sexual relations 6-9 months ago today. Yeah. Well, not today, you know what I mean. Don't know you. Okay, I'm about to give up here. I think we're down. I think we're at the bottom of the list now. I don't recognize none of these people here. I don't know you. Don't know you. I don't see... No. I thought I just put anybody's name on here. Shit. Okay, God, the list keeps going. I'm giving up right there. But that's some birthdays right there. Hopefully, you knew some of them. And probably some of them I went by. So we got Sebastian from Skid Row, Brook Group. Skid Row, remember that band? Is it his birthday? Sebastian. David Letterman's got a talk show on Netflix. He's got a big old beard. Yeah, I've seen that. I've seen a couple of them episodes there. Mr. Carter, I got a note. Yes, yeah, yes. Sam Talk Skywalker. Well, we'll get ready to hop in. We're going to talk. Oh, Ashley, there she is. When is your birthday, junkie? September 28th is my birthday. Robert Long says, sweat hogs. USF aluminum cans. I hate these cans. Lots of trips around the sun. That is true. Hey, Junkman, aluminum price is up. That shirt is too big. Yeah, I think the collar looks too big or something. I don't know. Usually they end up shrinking, especially when about a concert shirt. Richard Pryor is the reason for the live TV delay. Oh, I did not know that. I thought it was just use duck.go so you don't call it duck it. Okay. Well, let's hop over and talk 2,600 games. Before that, let's just watch a little video so I can refresh my... Here we go. Let's watch a fat guy fall down.
Of the Sith Army!
Poor little kid. Poor little kid right there. Okay, let's go. Let's talk 2,600. Now, I lost my list of names, so I'm going to go by these pictures. I hope I remember each one, so I might need you guys to help me. My computer crashed and it didn't save my file while I was writing down the names of each picture. So, oh, God, I'm going to cough again. Okay, I'll just mute instead. I'm playing cringy boyfriend, right? Don't forget, Super Chat, support the channel. Means a lot. Means he's helping out the channel. Make sure we do another Pop Culture in the Morning. Without Super Chats, you don't do Pop Culture in the Morning. But let's just stop. Pitfall. Has to be one of the first really great games for Atari 2600. A different game. You know, with the graphics really up their game for this game. This game really upped graphics. And you had, I think it just repeated. I don't think there was actually no end to it because it was time limit. But you had to find the gold bar. You had to find the ring, snake pit. I could never, ever, all those alligator heads. I finally got pretty good at it. But, I mean, I know some people could just boom, 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 right over those alligator heads. You had to stand on, like, their eyes. So when they opened their mouth, you didn't fall down in there. Man, I could not. Them alligators gave me a time, man. You had to hit it just right. Like I said, the back of the alligator, that was it. And combat. You can't talk Atari 2600 while talking combat. One of the original game. This is the one that actually came with the system. Maybe they changed it up later, but for most people, combat's the game it came with. It had the tanks, and then the higher levels have biplanes. I just remember that's how I knew the word biplanes, thanks to combat. I just called on planes before that. We got Ashley supporting the channel. Ashley's always here. September birthday for New Year's fun. Super, okay. September birthdays are I get what you're saying there, Ashley. I got you. Thanks for the super chat. It means a lot. So we're going to send this. Don't got any new. I need some more new clips. I know last night I was going to get some and I didn't. I'm sorry. We'll send this one out to you, Ash. Oh, the Star Wars kid. Okay, let's go. Can't play too much of that. It's got Star Wars music in it. Might cut me off there. Let's go. Let's see what's next. River Raid. I loved River Raid. Oh my God, did I love River Raid. Oof. River Raid, River Raid, River Raid. I really enjoyed that game right there. You had to fly over the fuel tanks to fill your airplane up. Good graphics for the time period, especially for Atari. I'm sure, I think I always saw someone say it in the chat. Ian, I think, said it. I was up too high now, I can't see it, but I think it was Ian. River Raid, what a lot of fun, a lot of fun. What about this? We're called Outlaws. Two cowboys. You got to shoot each other. Quick draw. You could even have a setting where you could kind of control the bullet. Weird. With the then you had some one level where you could have it ricochet, I think. But the cactus always got in the way. That thing in the middle, if you're new, if you're a millennial, you don't know about these old graphics. That thing in the middle is not a retarded pitchfork. It is a cactus. Believe it or not, that is a cactus. Outlaw. I really did enjoy playing that. And, of course, you can't talk early video games without talking Space Invaders. More of the arcade game, but the Space Invaders was the one of the founding fathers of video games. So I had to bring up Space Invaders. It was a lot of fun on Atari also. And, of course, you cannot talk 2600 games. Hell, you can't even talk the history of video games without bringing up Adventure. What a great game. Basic, simple, still hard. Level 3, I still can't hardly do level 3. That is hard. That damn red dragon will eat my ass every time. Getting through the mazes, I loved it. I loved that it had a little bridge where you could put it between the walls and kind of cheat. If you got it just right, if you put that bridge just right. Had a hidden code. You could find a hidden dot, take it to a hidden place. Go to a room you aren't supposed to go to and see the name of the maker of the game. Really great stuff. And I think that was worked into Player Ready 1. That's why I love that movie so much. I was like, I thought, oh man, Adventure. But what a great game. And you had to find the keys to each castle. And you had to find the gauntlet and take it back to the Yellow Castle. It was a great game and really advanced for its time. Another game I didn't bring up on here, it reminds me kind of Adventure, not as fun, was Haunted House. Anyone remember that? You had to build something, find pieces all through this haunted house. And ghosts would come out and blow your lantern out. You were just eyes. It was a really fun game, too. Asteroids. You can't talk Atari 2600 either while bringing up Asteroids. Also a very popular arcade game, which the Asteroids brought some color to it when it became a home video game for Atari. At least the earlier Asteroid games I remember didn't have any color. And Asteroids is fun as long as you don't set it on the wrong level. Where if you pull down on the controller, it makes your ship disappear and reappear somewhere else on the screen. And you want to keep that ship dead center, because that's mostly where you're not going to get asteroids. You go too far to the left, too far to the right, you're going to get your ass hit with asteroids. Keep that thing in the center. And my sister does not remember this, and I remember it to my day, and she's like, I don't know what you're talking about. She's the only person I ever seen. I saw it. She flipped the score on the 2600 game. She's like, I don't even remember playing that game. I was like, I remember you loved that game so much, you flipped the score. Well, she's only a whole four digits, so maybe it's not that hard, but she wasn't. I was impressed by it when I was little. She don't even remember it. And Yar's Revenge. What a great game. This was a lot of fun. Simple game. You had to take your little bug-looking ship and kill the main ship. Had a shield around it. You had a little thing in the middle you could hide out in so it couldn't get killed there. A lot of fun. Everybody remembers this, I'm sure. And this one here was a little bit more, the graphics, and I can't remember the name of it now because it's on my list. I think it was Kung Fu. It was a karate game. Somebody help me out in the chat. Okay, what? Okay, I'm sorry. I thought someone was saying the impossible mission for the Commodore 64 was a bad game, but he's talking to the worst. Okay. That game that says Stay a While. I love that game. I should have brought up some 64 some Commodore games on here, and I didn't, because my brother was part of a hacker group, and he had like a whole box of all kinds of every game he could think of. I don't know if it was a hacker group. They would just share games, copy games, man. Yeah. Mission Impossible. Stay a while. Stay forever. And they had the best when he fell in the hole. Karate Champ or Kung Fu. Somebody told me it was Karate Champ. Somebody else said it was Kung Fu. I'm not really sure. Ashley says E.T. We're not talking. That is one horrible game, isn't it? Super Breakout, or maybe just Breakout. But this is Super Breakout. Fun game, just kind of that party game when you have friends over, especially because this is one more, maybe your parents would play the Atari finally if you had Super Breakout. You had to use the paddles. I never liked to hook up the paddles. It's a lot of work. You had to unplug the joystick and plug the paddles in. And I always just like to take the paddles and use it as a camera because it looked like a camera. That was more fun to me than having to plug in everything. Oh, Jeff said he can beat E.T. You're one of the few people that can. That is horrible. I don't know how you can do it. Frogger. This was a good arcade brought over to the 2600, unlike Pac-Man. That wasn't any good. And the graphics was really decent for the time period for the 2600. Frogger was a lot of fun. I love it. One of my top five favorite games, probably. I love it. Raiders of the Lost Ark. Not just because I'm an Indiana Jones fan. Not because I like anything with Harrison Ford. I just really love this game. It's hard, it's challenging, but damn, it's fun and addictive. Once you know what to do, once you know how to get where you got to get and what you got to find, how to get, I mean, you got to find the map room. You got to get to the map room a certain time of day when the sun comes up, 12 o'clock. You got to have it on the headpiece and Staff of Ra. That way it shows you where the ark is. You got to buy the parachute. You got to buy the shovel. You got to watch out for the black market because them little things will steal your shovel and your money. If screw you all up and you start all over. Oh my God. This is genius, especially for the time period. And it's one of the few games on the 2600 that had an ending. The guy said he solved E.T., so it had an ending also. Very few games actually had an ending. And Raiders was one of those. Raiders All Star. I guess some people talk bad about it. But if you read the manual it came with, understood the game, man, it was a lot of fun. That parachute trying to get in that cave. Ooh, that was hard. But I got a video on my channel of me solving it. Still to this day I can play. I got me doing it. Check it out. Old video. Let's see. We are done with the 2600. We're going to hop over to NES in just a second. But let's catch up with some chats. Again, super chats to support the channel to make sure we keep doing pop culture in the morning. Because without super chats, there will be no pop culture show. Hey, Junkman. Happy popping morning. How many people we got here? 42. That's about normal for this show. Joust was fun. I know a lot of people like that game. I think Frogger is a BDS game. Man, you play a whole lot Frogger than I did. Hey, Junkman, happy popping morning. Thank you. Right there, we got the worst. After the show is over, I think I'm going to eat some cottage cheese with pears. Gross. That sounds nasty, but go right ahead. I found 100 copies of E.T. in a local dump. Okay, there. Johnny, I think I read that one already. You had to use a second controller for issue. You had to use a second controller for Indiana Jones. You did have to do that because the original controller you only had one button. Frogger and Jowl. So I love Raiders. Ashley loves Raiders. There we go. Ashley knows some good games. Raiders gets bad rap. But Sutton, Jim said the early PC games would have a cult following. Even the electronic sounds, they are so. Like I said, I should have pulled up some 64 games. I love some. Hero was one I love to play. Impossible Mission, someone talked about that. Classic, great game. I had one called Buzz USA. I used to love to play where you had to hop on this train, stop a virus from going all around. It was a lot of good games. A lot of good games for that. Miss Pac-Man is great, says Joe. I never played Miss Pac-Man. I played Pac-Man, and believe it or not, as much of a Miss Pac-Man fan I am, I never played it for the 2600. Spent hours playing Berserker. Everybody, that's a good game. It always comes up on everybody's list. Should have brought that one up. Really good game. With no cornflakes, with Pepsi. I don't know what y'all are talking crazy stuff over here. But let's go. We'll be right back to talk. It's Nintendo.
The decision is always yours, and your whole future may depend on making the right one. So no matter where you meet a stranger, be careful if they are too friendly, if they try to win your confidence too quickly, and if they become overly personal. One never knows when the homosexual is about. He may appear normal, and it may be too late when you discover he is mentally ill.
That's just wrong, man. That's just wrong. Ashley said they had to have a controller for left-handed people. I didn't know they made different controllers for left-handed people. I can see where there might be a problem with the button on that side, though. I can see that. Raw is supporting the show. He wants to see more pop culture in the morning. Raw, thank you so much. Moon Patrol. I remember the name, but I don't remember. But let's send my favorite clip out to Raw Solo.
Oh, no. Somebody's busted my antenna.
I love that clip right there. Oh, Joe says, my Dwight Yoakam shirt is cool. Thank you so much, man. Thank you. Dwight Yoakam is probably my favorite artist, singer of all time. I like a few others. I like all kinds of different kinds of music. But Dwight is the one that probably went to the most. I mean, that still puts out good stuff. You know, a lot of singers, I bought their albums when I was a kid. And then the albums kind of, you know, the more albums they put out, usually after a few years, they start dying out. But Dwight can still do good stuff. In Star Wars, you have to watch for the pansexuals. Oh, my God. Watch out, Lando. The pansexuals are coming. Dwight Yoakam in George Lucas video, Junkman. I don't know what in a George Lucas video. I don't know what that is. Maybe he is. I don't know. I know I've seen George Lucas in this video.
The interesting thing is they call it pyroprocessing, but it's a molten salt process. They're dissolving this thing in a molten salt.
Junkman's got to get some Magnum clips. I do. I got to get new clips. I'm sorry. I said I was going to start Monday with new clips every Monday, but then I get lazy and it's a pain in the ass some of them to get. It's good when I can find one that's the right length because I want just a few seconds and I can just download it off YouTube. But some of them I have to take a download, put it in the. For some reason, my QuickTime player, I can edit it in there, but it won't save it. It just spins around. Won't save. So I have to go into Final Cut Pro, upload it, pull it in there, cut it, trim it, save it again. I'm lazy. I'm lazy, but hey, it's part of the job, right? Part of the job. Jumpman, you're going to get, oh, I read that one already. But let's talk NES again. Hopefully, I think these are mostly covers, so I think I will know the name of these ones here. You need a video clip of that guy who says, stir whips, that's a good one. I do need that one. I'm glad you said that. Stir whip. I'm glad you said that one, Indiana Smith. Glad said that one. Who or what is Dwight Yoakam? Oh, my God. Guess you've never seen the movie Sling Blade. Turn me up, turn me loose. There you go. Oh, my God. I'm getting a text. That usually means somebody wants me. Okay. Here we go, guy. Mega Man 2. I put this one on this. Everybody seems... everyone talks about this one right here. I never really got into it. I mean, I played it a couple of times. But I didn't have it, so I can't really say. But everybody seems to really enjoy this one. It comes up on everybody's list. So, you guys out there who played it probably know about Mega Man 2 and know if it's a fun game or not. The Adventures of Link. Now, I like this. This game gets some bad rep so because it's not like the original. And that's what I like. I don't need it to be like original. You know. Like I like Temple of Doom because it's nothing like Raiders. I love Adventure of Link. Me and my sister used to play this one also. We stay up all night. I would watch her play it, stay up all night. Playing Adventure of Link. She was a lot better than I was. And she wasn't a video game person, but she liked playing Link and Mario, and I guess the Asteroids. Dr. Mario was a lot of fun. This was more fun for me when it's on handheld. I think I had it for the Game Boy, maybe, the original Game Boy, but there was a Nintendo version. All but it was just Tetris. It was like a fancy Tetris, but a lot of fun right there. Dr. Mario. Batman, one of the few video game, movie-based video games that was a lot of fun. I liked playing Batman. I don't know, maybe you guys out there. Of course, the Star Wars was good. Star Wars is probably one, not just because I love Star Wars. I mean, most of the movie video games were horrible. Star Wars was a high standard, and this Batman one I thought was pretty fun. I didn't own it. I remember renting it Back then when you could rent video games from Blockbuster or whatever. It wasn't Blockbuster then. It was some probably local video warehouse, some local place. Bringing it home, playing it. I think Batman was purple, if I remember right, or just had a purple tint to him. But I remember playing this. Somebody talked about this the other day in the room. Again, a real popular game. I had a friend named Nick. He really loved to play this game. I never really played it much, but it's on everybody's list of favorite games. I used to think it was called Ninja Garden for a long time, and that's just because I'm stupid and I can't read. Duck Hunt. Nah, I didn't know. I wasn't one of those spoiled kids that had the gun. I had the robot, like Boyd. He got the robot with his Nintendo. I was like, I got Nintendo, and then he got one about 6 months later. I got it with the robot. And the gun. I didn't even get the gun. I just got the robot. So I never played Duck Hunt until I went to friends' houses and played it. And it was fun. He got the gun, the zapper gun. It was fun shooting at the screen. Hated that dog. I was like, oh, that dog's laughing at me. I didn't like to get laughed at by a dog. I don't like to be laughed at by anybody. I really don't like to be laughed at by a dog. Kid Cornelius here, another popular game. I put this on a list. Everybody's one of these games people seem to love. I don't remember this game. I mean, I don't remember playing. I remember the box. Remember hearing about it. Remember reading about it in Nintendo Power. Remember people talking about it. But I don't remember if I've ever played it or not. So I can't really comment much on it. Maybe you in the chat can. Excite Bike. Fun, classic game in the original black Nintendo box. One of the original games. Excite Bike was a lot of fun. You could make your own tracks. Well, they said you could make your own tracks. Guess I just wasn't that talented to make my own tracks because I was sucked at it. Could never really figure it out. But I did have a game called Load Runner for Commodore 64. I think they also made it for Nintendo, and I loved it. Load Runner. You run around, drop these little holes, and these little guys would fall in the holes, and you had to get the ladder or something. But you can make your own levels on it, and I would spend hours, all night making my own levels. Man, I loved Load Runner. Classic, too. One of the top five best games, probably. Punch Out. Me and my son still play this sometime. One of the few games I can still play on Nintendo that doesn't bore the shit out of me within 30 seconds. Mike Tyson's Punch Out. Now, of course, they changed the name, took Mike Tyson off later. But Mike Tyson Punch Out. What a great game, man. I could never beat Mike Tyson. One punch. Boom! Mike Tyson knocked my ass out, man. I could not. I couldn't even hit him one time. Couldn't even last a few seconds. Mike Tyson, what a great game. Castlevania, the classic Castlevania. I love this game. This game was a lot of fun. Wasn't really good at it. Couldn't get really far. Probably couldn't get past level 2 or 3, but I would play it over and over again back when I could start over. Now, like I said, I try to play this game now, and the first time I die, I'm like, I can't play this anymore. Odd how I could play it for hours, wasn't good at it, and now I can't even play it for 30 seconds. Contra, up, up, down, down, left, right, A, B, A, B, A, B, start, something like that. The Contra code, everybody knows the Contra code, right? Contra was a great game. I love this. I could solve it without the code. I didn't even need the code, but I always used the code anyway. I love Contra. Have it for my Nintendo Mini, and I can't get past level 1. I can't even get past level 1 now. I think it's the controller. Something about that controller is not like the original controller. It throws me off. I don't know what it is, but man. Metroid, another game, everybody's favorite game. Again, this is one, I know it's a famous game. I know my friend, I had another friend named Nick that had it. He played at his house, but I don't remember much about it. But he was really into it. Super Mario 3, you can't talk Nintendo. I mean, all three Super Marios are excellent games, high-level games. I mean, when it came to the Mario games, they were higher standard than your normal Nintendo games. When the graphics looked better, gameplay was better. I mean, you can't talk. It's probably Super Mario 3 might be the best designed game for the system. Now, I'll say it's the best game, you know, but probably the best laid out, designed, graphic-wise, playable game. Probably the best overall game. Maybe not the most fun, but probably most fun, too. Tetris, another one I had for Game Boy, more of a Game Boy game, but Tetris was a lot of fun. Although it came from Russia, I know a lot of people was like, oh, Cold War era, they're like, I'm not playing anything that comes from Russia. So a lot of people probably didn't want to play it, but I had a lot of fun playing it. The Legend of Zelda, Everybody loved this game. Everyone told me to play it. I could not get into it. I'm sorry. I know it's a classic. It's like right up there with Mario when it comes to Nintendo games. It just bothered me that it was like Skyview, but I could see his face when he walked around, and I couldn't figure it out. I was like, okay, I'm looking down at it, but then I see his face. It's like he was walking on his side. I couldn't. It just bothered me too much, and I couldn't get past it. I know, odd reason not to be able to play a game. Super Mario, the original, to me, probably the best ever home video game ever is Super Mario. I don't care any other game. There's a lot of good games. Just this was simple. This is when if you're new to video games, you can pick the controller up, you can go. It's simple, it's fun, it still holds up today, still very fun today. This is one of the few games I can still sit there and play all day. Love it. I could jump on turtle shells, I could make them slide on 1 foot, I could jump over the flagpole and 1-3. I could find the secret world that was a world that you had to go through a pipe to get to, -1. Didn't really do nothing, it was just a loop where you ran out of time over and over again. Oh, and I could jump on the turtle shell. Never turtle shell. Only time you say turtle shell in the world is when you talk Mario. I could jump on the turtle shell and get the free 100 men, but if you get more than that, you'll die. Super Mario 2. Like I said, you can't talk Nintendo games while bringing up Super Mario. And this game was huge. I don't know how many people out there remember when Mario 2 came out. It was huge. Now, I know that's not the same as Super Mario 2 in Japan. That's really called Dream Daka Duka Doo. And they just put Mario on it for the U.S. market. Okay, we know all that. We know all that. And we're not going to talk about all that. Mario 2, it was fun. It was a little different than Mario, so I know it probably threw some people off. But this was like Cabbage Patch Dolls. You could not find this at the store. I remember my mom got it for me for Christmas on a radio auction, and you would call the auction. They were bidding back and forth. I think she paid like $90 for it. It was crazy at the time. I was like, man, I don't know. It was probably $60 when it came out, though. Crazy. Great game. Great fun. A lot of fun. Still play this, man. It was a lot. Graphics look good. Really great game. Now, one of my personal favorite games. I never knew for sure how to say. I used to call it Milton's Castle, and people get mad at me. Mylon's Secret Castle. Love this game. Everybody, and this game gets ragged on a lot. It's hard, don't get me wrong. And a lot of people think that once you die, you only get one life and you have to start all over. But the thing was, if you had to hold, it was either up or down, I think, on the controller and hit start, it would start you where you left off. But a lot of people just didn't know that. It was hard as hell, but once you figured out where to go, a lot of people I know couldn't even get off of level 1, didn't know what to do. But once you could move around and find out what you're doing, it was a lot of fun. I never did solve it. I mean, I got very, very far on it, but that's the thing about these games. They didn't come with a code, so once you died or got tired of playing, you had to start all over. It didn't have a code. And another one I really loved, but I went back and tried to play it not too long ago. It was horrible. I couldn't get Time Lord. I don't hear the people talk about this game much. It was made by Milton Bradley. He had to find these orbs through different time periods, and I really, really liked this game. It never really took off. Kind of probably later in the series when people was getting out Nintendo right before Super NES came out. But I don't hear people talk about it, but I really do enjoy it. Tecmo Baseball, another one I really like. I'm not a sports guy, but I love baseball games for video systems. Tecmo Baseball, I remember playing this with my sister. We loved playing baseball. I can still remember they didn't have the official titles of players or sports teams, just the cities. And I remember if you had New York and you had Duncan, he's going to hit a home run 6 out of 10 times, man. Duncan was, I can still remember, oh, man, pitching to my sister had New York. And it's like, here comes Duncan. Shit. Had to watch what you threw because Duncan was going to knock it out of the park. And Mega Man 2, I talked about that. Okay, let me refresh my voice here. We'll let you look at this here. We'll be right back, guys.
Hi, baby girl. Everything's okay, I promise. I forgive you. It's okay, don't worry about it. Everything's gonna be okay. I love you. I love you so much.
I love you more than man, that's some creepy shit. Okay, but it's a long video, so I can play a long... That's one of the long videos I can play without having to worry about copyright. Dang it, Raw, let's catch up in some of the chats now. I didn't miss anything here. See what some people saying about the games. We got about Tecmo sports games are super popping. They were pretty good. It was a football one. I never had that. I was more into baseball games. Let's see if Zelda had battery. Zelda didn't have battery in it. I remember that. Ashley said something and deleted it. Dan says the best. It's the best Super Mario Brothers. He must be talking about number two. Took me years to beat Mike. I don't know how I still can't beat Mike to this day. Jeff said I had a description of Nintendo Power. Still have them somewhere. I wish someone would make a well-sized poster of the Zelda map. Oh, that would be pretty cool in the first issue. I would love to have that first issue of Mario. I'd love to have that first issue. That first one and the last one I think I would love to have. But I think they go for a lot. At least the first one does. And the last issue of Nintendo Power has Mario's same cover. Just done differently. Creepy Teen is still around. Blades of Steel was a good one right there. It was a good hockey game. What about Bases Loaded? Remember that? I never had Bases Loaded. That was always like the go-to baseball game. I should have had that one as much as I like playing baseball. The Television and ColecoVision were both cool. My friend Boyd had it in Television, but I don't remember much other than the controllers. Didn't like the controller like a phone. The worst place of Jellyman Kelly. He didn't even send a super chat, man. We'll see. We'll see if you get lucky. We'll see. Keep it. What about some games that are horrible? There's some horrible Nintendo games. Top Gun. Hated Top Gun. Bought it at Zaire's. Got home. Hated. RC Pro-Am. Joe says that was a fun game. I like that one. I forgot about that. That's a fun game. But Top Gun, I hated. Could not ever land on that aircraft carrier. Oh my God, I couldn't land on that thing. Robert said they made two Star Wars games. He said, yeah, the Star Wars and Empire Strikes Back game. Pretty hard games, but funny fun. Chris says, Lover Boy. Action 52 was a good game. Double Dribble. Oh yeah, actually, Double Dribble was a popular game for baseball. I don't know if I ever played it. I rented a Rare's Waldo game. After my eyes were bleeding, it was horrible. Where do you hide the body? Dang it. Ice Hockey was a fun one, says Samantha the Sledgehammer. Auto Racing Games. What was another racing game? It wasn't Pole Position, but it was like a Ferrari. It was an arcade game, but I think they also made it on Nintendo. Somebody let me know. Commando was great. I don't know if I remember that one. I have to see the cover. Oh, you're talking about Dave Crane. Okay, somebody's talking about Dave Crane. The guy who played Pitfall also made a boy in his blah for Nintendo. The guy that made. Maybe that's Dave Crane. How expensive were games in the 80s? They run you about $50 to $60 for a Nintendo game back in the day, if I remember correctly. So, really about what they are today, believe it or not. But today, it seems like, well, mobile games, you got to keep buying shit for. Rad Racer, was it Rad Racer? I don't think that was the name of it. Let me look up Rad Racer real quick. Rad Racer. Maybe that was it. Huh. That might have been it. That looks like that might have been. I was thinking it was more something cool. Rad Racer. I remember Rad Racer, but I don't think that was the one I'm thinking of. This was more like people at the beach, sunglasses on, had a Ferrari. What was that? Okay, did you play a Star Trek game? I remember playing a few Star Trek games I would rent. They were always really boring or hard. I could never outrun. Let's see what Outrun is. That sounds familiar. Outrun video game. Outrun a video game. Mm-hmm. Outrun, that is it. Thank you, that is it. That's the one I was thinking of. Yeah, Outrun. It was like, at the time, it was like pretty weird, like wild cartoon graphics. It was really new. Yeah, that's what, thank you. Dominic told me that, but who told me first? Oh, Dominic said it 3 or 4 times. Outrun. You're right. Outrun. And then Dominic's telling me again the game is Outrun. Matt said, Junkman, do you have and of the Super Mario 1983 movie figures. I don't have any of the movie figures. I don't have any of them. By 1993, when that movie came out, I didn't care about figures, but I was probably starting to get into figures again by that time. But I didn't care about that movie. The action, the 83. Was that movie 83? I was thinking it was earlier than that. The Activision guy just came out with a new 2600 game called Circus Convoy. That's a cool name for a game. That sounds fun. You know, there's an Adventure 2. It was on my Atari. I bought one of those Ataris that do the TV has games built into it. Adventure 2 was in it. I couldn't get into it, but I always like, man, maybe back in the day, because it wasn't released, I think. It was never released for Atari. I think it was planned, and they finished it for that console or something. Maniac Mansion is another one. People talk about that. Future, yeah, says that, and I think George Lucas' childhood home. Huh. Oh. Also, man, he likes Maniac Mansion, and it's George Lucas' children's home. Childhood home. I didn't know it had anything to do with George Lucas, but Maniac Mansion, yeah, I forgot about that one. I had a game called, not Rakitu. I had some games for the TRS-80 that were like text-based game. It was like, you started in a prison cell. You had to like, okay, look to the left to see if you see a key. And it's like, you look to the left, but all you see is dirt or something. Remember those games? They were kind of fun. Road Blaster, Spy Hunter. Actually, Spy Hunter was one I really did enjoy. I did like Spy Hunter. Junkman, how about some early PC games? TV ads as clips. That might be good. I'm going to look into that. Road Blaster was fun. I remember a Zorro game, too. I think it was for the Commodore 64. I really like playing. Did you replace Super Spy Hunter? No. I don't know what I mean by replaced. Top Gun with a joystick was... Top Gun with joystick was awesome. I don't know. Maybe so. I had the radio control, and I could not ever land on that aircraft carrier. Hate it. I was like, oh, I hate this game. This is probably the last Nintendo game I bought, too, probably. The last Atari 2600 game I bought was Jedi Arena. Oh, man.
Son of a bitch. Hey, Jumpman channel popping, though.
Okay, there we go. Let's see here. Good call, Samantha. Samantha says Double Dragon like everybody. Yeah, Double Dragon is a very popular game that people seem to love. Load Runner says, actually, we talked about that a few minutes ago. I loved Load Runner, making my own levels. Man, what a great game. Oh, man, one for the 64 I really love called Seven Cities of Gold. You were like Christopher Columbus, man. You had to go discover this island, meet the natives, trade with them, and everything. The graphics wasn't great, but man, did I love that. Seven Cities of Gold. I love that game. I would love to find a mobile game like that. I've seen some other ones. They're never the same. Tabletop version, the popular arcade game. What about Bagman? I don't know what the hell Bagman is, man. You got me on that one, Ashley. Let's see. Bagman. Bagman video game. That sounds crazy. Bagman. She looks like it's some kind of like Dig Dug ripoff, huh? Don't know if I remember that. I remember a place, we had a little teen bar. It was like a club for teens. Had a Mario game. It looked like Mario, but he was on a skateboard. I don't know if someone hacked into it, made their own version or something. It was weird. But actually, you got me on that one. I don't remember Bagman. It looked like some kind of Dig Dug like game. Remember Burger Time? Drunk Man was cool, but hard as shit. What the heck? Dark Man. Oh, Dark Man from the movie game. Yeah, I remember playing. I don't remember much about it. There we go. Dark Man. Mike Tyson's Punch Out was always fun. Yeah, great game right there. I never liked that Super Punch Out when they tried to do a sequel to it. Oh, wasn't good. They changed it too much. What about Metal Gear? Metal Gear Solid, great game also. Should have been on my list. TRS-80, that's going back way back. Yeah, I had a TRS-80. Used to love to program it. Make my own games. You know. When I could program. Not very simple games, nothing. Nintendo's Mission Impossible was hard game. I remember that one being hard. I remember somebody I knew had that. Miner 249er. I've got a picture. I think I've talked about it before I showed it in a video. I got a picture at the bottom of my stairs. That's all a bunch of Atari games in the picture. And I always catches that Miner 2049er, and I always think about that when I'm about to come up here to go to the junk room. So it's funny you said that. Morning, Junkman, says Star Wars agent coming in late to the house. Darkman was a very good game. Top Gun isn't fun with the regular controllers. I'll take your word for it. I couldn't get past the landing trick to Paul's tabletop Pac-Man, okay? Beer Tapper. Beer Tapper. I love Tapper. With the little bartender guy. That was like my first C4 game. Slide it down the bar. Oh, yeah. I used to love that. Root Beer Tapper. They had a bunch of those Tapper games. Just changed the format. Marvel Madness was a really fun one. Marvel Madness was a good one there. Love Miners. I don't think I ever played Miner 29er. 2049er. I don't think I need a mic. Like yours, bro, going live tonight, talking about Art Bell. Oh, Art Bell. I might have to come up. If I'm not busy or I find your channel, I might have to talk about it. I love hearing about Art Bell. But you can pick up that mic. You can pick up a Yeti mic. Not much. Might have 120, I think. Probably can find it cheaper than that if you look around on Amazon. Good mic. Good mic. The Goonies 2 game. There was no Goonies 1 game, and there was no Goonies 2 movie. What's up with that? Marvel Madness, as she says, is good. Enter the Matrix. Matrix was crap. I don't remember that one. There were a lot of crap games. Jekyll and Hyde. I thought that was going to be like Castlevania. I was all excited. It was horrible. Back to the Future. God, that game was... I hated that game. Bill and Ted's game. Oh, hated that. A lot of movie games were horrible. It's like, how did this even get released? But guys, we're hour in. Looking at the chat here. I want to get, thank you for the super chats we did get. Thank you for supporting the channel. Thank you for coming over live. Don't forget, 7 o'clock tonight, we will be back live for Indiana Jones Talk Wednesday. Indiana Wednesday. Samantha said, you ever played Ghostbusters? I never did, but it's one of my favorite Angry Video Nerd things. I had it for 64, I think. I liked playing it on the 64. Never played the Nintendo one. I don't know if it was about the same. It looked about the same. So, can't say if I ever played it, but I did. Ghostbusters! I think the sound quality was a little better on the 64 game. Seemed like it had more of a movie sound. I could have some fun. Gave me fun with anyone in this room would be fun right there. Nintendo Superman fun was really, really fun. Okay, guys, I'm going to get out of here, work on a 5 o'clock video. We'll see you at the daily video today at 5 o'clock. And then, Indiana Jones Talk tonight at 7. Hope you would join me then. I want to thank you guys again for the support and the love, and share the channel so everyone can find out about the Junkman. We will talk again soon. Thanks, guys.
Huh? All right, fellas, and away we go.
Thank you, sir, for that.